Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 13.4 has been out for a few days. I've been using it on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, as well as some older devices as well, and I've been looking at the YouTube community poll that I actually launched today, but I wanted to record this a little bit early, and most people are saying this is pretty good. So I'll talk about my experience, then your experience, then we'll talk about the YouTube community poll, and I'll read some of your comments. Now, I've been using this on my iPhone 11 Pro Max and my iPad Pro 12.9, and I'm happy to say most of the time I have no issues. It's smooth and fast. I've had no lag or slowdowns or anything like that. And also, I've had very good battery, but I'll talk more about that in a moment. Now, as far as any weird bugs or things that I've had, well, if I connect my AirPods Pro, the little volume slider here actually shows PowerBeats Pro. So I'm not sure why that is. I've tried disconnecting and reconnecting them, and so they show up wrong. So that's something I'm seeing. It's not a big deal, but it's something that's not correct. And then also 3D pressing, this is a hit or miss. Some people are saying they're seeing this, but if you 3D press or haptic press on settings and then tap on Bluetooth, it opens sometimes for some people and other times it will crash. Now on beta 5, it was crashing for people. On the GM or beta 6, it's not crashing for me most of the time. In fact, I was able to have it crash one or two times and then it hasn't done it since. So I'm not sure what the difference is, but right now it seems to be pretty good. Now the only other issue I'm having is with mail. It's kind of strange. Sometimes it will show my email that's new. Sometimes it won't. Sometimes it's showing the right number. Sometimes it isn't, and it basically has to be opened in order to refresh. So Apple really needs to fix this, and I know I'm not the only one that's bothered by it, but hopefully they fix it soon, or I'm going to have to switch to something else just to make sure that I'm getting all my email. Now, as far as battery life is concerned, this was actually pretty impressive, I thought. When I went into my battery life, when I was doing some other videos today, you'll see my health is at 100%. And for those of you that don't follow me regularly, I do charge every night, and I charge when I'm driving. Otherwise, I don't pay attention to the battery, I just use it. And so this is my daily phone since September, and it's holding up pretty well. Now, if we go over the last 10 days, you can see on a couple days ago, I had 4 hours and 56 minutes of screen on time, and I was about 40% of my battery life. So 30 to 40%, I'm getting phenomenal battery life with this. So if I continued to use it, I would easily hit the 10 to 12 hour screen on time mark, and I had 35 minutes of screen off time. So this is going to vary depending on what you're doing, but most people are saying it's great. And I read all the comments on the YouTube community poll, and only two or three people said that they were seeing the same or worse battery life than the current version, but almost everyone else said that battery life is fantastic. Now, battery life has been really great for me and for most of you, like I said, but as far as RAM management, almost everyone again says that it's fixed or it's working the way you would expect. So what that means is how many times you have to go into an app and have it reload. So I find that I can load about 20 applications without them reloading after a little while. So if I go into music and then I open up something else and then go into, say, Amazon or photos or camera, and then go back to, say, YouTube, it seems like it's working fine without reloading, unless it needs to just refresh the screen because it's old content. So it's doing pretty well overall. And that includes old devices as well. This is probably the smoothest and fastest I've seen on old devices, such as the 6S Plus, the iPhone 7, or any supported device. Most people are saying performance is really great. So the same smooth scrolling that I'm having in settings, for example, should work fine on older devices as well. I know a lot of people were saying that they're concerned about older devices slowing down, but it doesn't seem to be the case with this update. So Apple has finally nailed this down and made it work very well. And so it doesn't seem to be what device you're using. It can be an iPad Air 2. It can be an iPhone SE. They all seem to be performing really well. Now, as far as overall issues mentioned that were major, 18 people mentioned battery, most of them saying it's good. 3 people mentioned RAM management. Again, all but one saying it's good. And then 9 people mentioned mail having an issue with it. So most people are having that mail issue, but LTE and Wi-Fi have been great for most. If you're still having an issue, you may want to check your Wi-Fi router, as Wi-Fi and LTE seem to be fixed in this version. So hopefully it stays this way for everyone. Now, here's all the devices that people are using. I took these out of the YouTube community poll and just pasted them here based on what people are using. So lots of different devices, and this should give us a general idea of what's going on. Now let's go into the YouTube community poll. Now, as for the YouTube community poll, I posted it only 4 hours ago. I wanted to get a jump on this today since it's been kind of a crazy week. And so I wanted to get ahead on that. And you'll see 3.8K have voted. So I really appreciate that many people voting in such a short period of time. And you'll see, based on this data, 17% say it's great, 2% say it's terrible, and 4% say okay, but some bugs. So in general, 6% are either having issues or saying it's bad, and 62% of you are waiting for that final release, which is coming on Tuesday, according to Apple and Mac Rumors. So they said Tuesday, we should see the final release. And then 15% said they use Android. This is pretty consistent every poll. So whoever keeps voting, I really appreciate it. Now let's take a look at some of the comments. Now I've read every single one of them. That's where I got the data for this video. So let's take a look at some of them. I have the GM on my iPhone 7 and iPad Air 3, and it's pretty good. No issues. My 11 Pro has been off freezing and apps crashing recently on iOS 13.3.1. The next one says, forgot the I just want to see results option. There's not enough room to actually put that in the poll, unfortunately. So hopefully people are voting accurately, but I put the maximum amount of information I can as far as a poll result. iOS 13.4 GM, so claimed, has no changes in it. Still has a commonly known bug where the screen dims and auto brightness is still off. This happens only majority of the time when the iPhone is plugged into the charger. iPhone SE working great on my device. This is the most stable release for me with no issues, and battery life is also quite good. All things good on my iPhone 11, no lagging, apps all run great, battery life on par, mail is happy again. Overall, A++. Now let's move forward to iOS 14 betas. Working better for me than 13.3.1. So far, I haven't come across any bugs with 13.4 on my iPhone 10. iOS 13.4 GM on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, smooth sailing here, no issues to report. Great on Pro Max and iPad Pro. The mouse is a little jerky or slower now, but no major issues. And you can actually change the pointer speed in 13.4 or iPadOS 13.4. Great so far, my iPhone SE. The screen freezing seems to have stopped now. Great videos. Oh, thank you for the compliment. Great on my iPhone XS Max. I'm using the betas on a Product Red iPod Touch 7th Gen. It works amazing despite the chip setup. Been using iOS 13.4 GM since release on my iPhone 11. Great battery life, no lag or stutter. My favorite beta yet. XS Max, one of the best updates since 13.0. Got 7 gigs back from the beta 5 to 6. Super smooth and no bugs to complain about. Battery on my iPhone XR is great. iOS 13.4 Beta 6 GM on my iPhone 11 Pro Max has been great, no issues whatsoever. Looking forward to iOS 14 betas. Really great battery life. Overall RAM management is absolutely up to the mark. iPhone 11. iOS 13.4 Beta 6 is the best version of iOS 13 on my 6S. Battery life is good and better than on iOS 13.1.1. iPhone 10, best update since iOS 13 release. Native mail app, still not perfect. Requires manual swipe to receive an inbox. Battery life and RAM management, okay. iPhone XR, some bugs in Photos and iTunes where the bottom navigation bar disappears. iTunes sometimes goes light everywhere when on light mode, so the movies section, for instance, will be white instead of black on light mode. Generally stable. Using it since release, modifying volume when using headphones present with annoying bug. Sometimes apart from that, it's running pretty good. iPhone 8 Plus. That's it for iOS 13.4, and you can expect the final version on Tuesday, according to Apple, unless something changes. But with that new iPad announcement and new things coming out, we really need that update for this to work properly. So I'm sure it will be out this week. Now, the other thing is iOS 14. We may see it in June. There's some weird things going on right now, as all of us know, so it's hard to say if they're going to keep the same timeline, but hopefully we see that. And so we could see 13.4.1 with some minor security or bug fixes. We could also see 13.5 beta 1 before September. So I would expect those betas, if they're going to come out, within a couple weeks, and we'll see this one this coming week. But let me know your experience in the comments below if you weren't able to get in on that poll early enough. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.